Hey everyone, welcome back to the Sunny Side, where we have weekly love horoscopes, fun astrology stuff, guided hypnosis style meditations, of course, and some waking hypnosis and NLP videos if you're interested. Hi everyone, I'm Sunny, and today I'm going to tell you guys which zodiac signs make the most money. Alright, but first things first. Making or attracting money isn't really the domain of any one sign in particular, although some signs are clearly better at it than others. It's actually a second or eighth house kind of thing. So even if your sign is not listed here, doesn't mean that you're not ever going to be rich. It just means you have to do a little tinkering. And before we get to the list, I'll show you guys how to do it. And before I forget, thanks in advance for sharing the video on Facebook or in a YouTube playlist, you know, and if you like it, give it a thumbs up. Anyways, here we go. First, look at your personal chart. It looks like this. Alright, and then go to the second house. It'll have a number two beside it. Or go to your eighth house. There's an axis here, a financial axis. And if there are no planets there, and this is a simplified explanation, of course, and of course there could be planets that obviously take your money away as well, you know, just saying. But if nothing's going on in your money houses, the first thing you should do is find someone who has planets in their chart that fall into your astro, one of your money houses, your second or your eighth house. And it's that simple, really. And I say it all the time. Together, it's a beautiful day. So, step one. If there's no money in your chart, go find it. Go find someone whose planets fall into your chart. So, here we go. Two people who individually don't have any astrological blessings in the money houses initially can become very wealthy together if one or both people have planets in each other's money houses. And you see this all the time. Some people are completely useless by themselves, but are suddenly way over the top successful when paired with the right person. So, careful who you choose to hang out with. Wait, there's a little more. Just as they can add money to your chart, people with other planets can easily take money out of your chart, take money away from you. So, heads up, you know, this is kind of important. So, like, be aware of who you hang out with and what is going on with your exchange of energy. Anyways, another way to do it is to move to a different city in a different time zone. This will rotate your entire chart. So in some places, you make a ton of money, just a ton. And in others, you make nothing. And again, I'm oversimplifying things, but it's essentially the action. It's how to manipulate your chart and your natural gifts to your personal advantage. If you move to a different city, it'll bump the planets into different houses and literally change your luck. But once again, I'll say it again, there are planets that take things away from you. So if they end up in your, if you move and they end up in your money house, that's a bad thing. Just saying. So if you're looking for money in your horoscope, that's what you do. And if you need any help, just leave all the questions in the comment section below and I'll answer them in the weekly Love Horoscopes video. Or send me a message and see if I can help. Anyways, here we go. The top five money-making signs. Top five money-making zodiac signs. Now, this list wasn't easy. Yes, there are some clear winners, but rounding out the top six was difficult. So, today, it's only a top five with a couple of honorable mentions and wild cards. And here we go. Doo-doo-doo. Number five, Leo. Yup, Leo. What you say, Sonny? Leo's only number five? Good question. In financial astrology, Leo rules gold. So if you follow financial astrology, then you'll quickly see that things that influence Leo also influence the gold market. Remember, I've been saying all year that Leos are so hot attracting money right now that they should be buying lottery tickets. Well, if you've been following the markets, you'll see the gold prices have also been rising. Pretty neat, huh? Okay, here's the real deal. Leos shine, and their light is attractive, so people are always giving them stuff. They're natural leaders, so as the boss, they naturally get paid more. Also, Leos are always the center of attention, so in business, it should be no surprise to see them at the center of financial transactions. It just makes sense. Leos are super lucky, you know? So making money through gambling, you know, at the casino or through speculative ventures in the stock market, or simply buying lottery tickets, should all be super high on the Leo money-making agenda. Because, well again, they're lucky, and they excel at games of chance. So number 5, Leo. Number 4, Cancer. What? Number 4, Cancer. Our favorite homemaker is not only our most selfish sign, and are most likely to get arrested for stalking sign, they're also amazing with money. Now you ask, how can such a messy and all over the place sign possibly be good with something that you should track, constantly look at, and generally focus and work towards? And we all know that Cancers move sideways, and that's not exactly how either attraction or building wealth actually works. Long-term success requires focus and determination, and Cancer is all about shelling up and running away when the going gets tough. Yes, but in financial astrology, Cancer represents the moon, and by extension, silver. So, just like Leo and gold, if you follow the blessings of Cancer, then you'll also be following the silver market. But there's more. There's more. Cancers take care of the home, and that's everything about the home, including finances. So remember, Cancers live to nurture and take care of others, and you can't do that if you're always broke. Cancers, along with Taurus, maybe Scorpio a bit, are also the worst hoarders and pack rats of the zodiac. They simply hold on to things. So, it's not unusual to go through a Cancer stuff and find seriously valuable treasures. They have significantly appreciated over time. You wouldn't normally guess it by looking at them. After all, they don't usually dress to impress. You know, they prefer comfortable clothes that they can, well, you know, like clean the house in, or garden in, or like do their art in. But a Cancer's bank is fat. So don't let their appearance fool you. Number 4 is Cancer. Next, number 3. And you guys know these guys are going to make the list. Number 3 rules other people's money, inheritances, behind the scenes power, and they are master manipulators. And that's Scorpio. Yep, the zodiac bad boy easily makes the list. Not because they're the most likely to become wealthy by robbing banks or swindling people in pyramid schemes or seducing older men and women out of their money, all of which they do wonderfully, by the way. Scorpio is an exceptionally strong worker, and they are brainers who take care of others. They're also ruled by Pluto, which is the planet of power. So it's easy to see Scorpios in leadership roles in business. Although, they do prefer to step back and be investors instead. Just saying. Anyways, they love the power that accompanies financial success. So you'll see these guys working really hard to achieve their goals. They are also determined and singularly focused, so they set a target and they go get it. They're not necessarily lucky in games of chance like Leo or Sagittarius, but Scorpio is psychic, so it does help a bit at the casino and racetrack. Anyways, by and large, Scorpio is usually the real power behind the throne, so to speak, and they're damn sure to make sure, you know, that they get paid for their work. So number 3, Scorpio. Next, all right, now it gets easier. Number 2, and you guys should be able to guess this one, Capricorn. Capricorn is our most ambitious sign, even bigger than Leo, and Leos think really big and really showy. And although Capricorn is reserved by nature, especially when it comes to like seduction or dating or something, or publicly going after things, they're always on when it comes to their career objectives. These guys, like Scorpio, are tireless workers. In any field, they can be found putting in extra hours to bring home the bacon. And this is important because, believe it or not, Capricorns are family guys. They're on the taking care of things axis. You know, on one end we have Cancer, who takes care of the home, and on the other side we have Capricorn, who takes care of the business. In astrology, Capricorn is also the domain of the 10th house, and that astro sector is all about your public working career. No, it's not your everyday working tasks, you know, that's Virgo, but it's your career and place in the world at large. Capricorn is steady and focused and our most upwardly mobile sign. By nature, they are hardwired to constantly go for the best in their career. They're excellent business leaders. They plan and execute their plans without fear or reservation. Simply, these guys have financial goals that resonate at a soul and personal level, and making money to take care of everyone is their number one priority. So, it's no surprise to see them ranking so highly. So, number two is Capricorn. Next, a couple of honorable mentions. Aries gets a mention here. Okay, why, Sonny? Okay. Well, Aries is super competitive, and this can lead, obviously, to some seriously strong career successes. But Aries takes way too many chances, and they make way too many mistakes. And in money, that's a no-no. Aries does not make this list. Another honorable mention, Pisces. You know, because Pisces, if they're in the right environment, they can excel at anything. These guys are actually a wild card in almost anything. But being a wild card doesn't get you on the money list. And if in the wrong environment, Pisces can easily lose themselves in drugs and alcohol for extended stretches, and obviously that's bad for business. Okay. Last honorable mention, and I guess this one is the major wild card, Aquarius. Now, Aquarius rules the 11th house, and that's the money you make from your work. It's also public recognition and rewards for a job well done. So, Sonny, how come they don't make the list? Well, as much as we want to reward Aquarius for a job well done, these guys are super humanitarian. And like Pisces, who's always supporting the underdog, giving money to good causes is great for the soul, but it's actually the opposite of accumulating wealth. And although these guys are smart and well capable of paying their own bills, it's just not a priority. And I'll say it again. Aquarius does not make the list because giving away everything away is kind of the opposite of keeping everything. Okay. So that brings us to our number one money making zodiac sign is Taurus, for obvious reasons. Tons and tons of obvious reasons. First, Taurus rules the second house in astrology, and that's your money house. So regardless if you like the list or if you disagree with parts, Taurus energy rules money and personal finances, period. Next, Taurus is greedy, even more so than Leo, and they don't like to share. It's kind of hilarious, you know? Like Taurus, our laziest sign, thinks they did it on their own. I do understand, but sometimes Taurus greed is just too much. Just saying. They want to own and possess everything. Some people like it, some don't. So again, they're greedy, and they don't like to share. They are also, like many of the other signs here, tireless workers. Endurance is the domain of these guys, this financial axis. And the two signs that really can go on forever and ever are Scorpio and Taurus. And you really don't want to fight these guys. The only problem is, Taurus, once again, can be lazy and complacent. But it's lazy and complacent while filling their pockets. What else? Taurus is about comfort and security. Taurus does not take financial risks. They are steady. They are not aggressive investors, but they do know a good investment when they see it. These guys invest in things like real estate, blue chip stocks, things with a history of growth that have every indication of continuing that steady growth for a long time. Taurus is fixed earth. That means slow, progressive growth. Will they go to the casino and loosen up? Of course! They love breaking up the boredom with fun. But unlike Leos, who can become professional gamblers, Taurus will just go for fun. They are smart, peaceful, and ruled by Venus, which is the planet of attraction. And actually, almost any way you slice or look at it, Taurus is sleeping on fat stacks. And as much as I try and look at it from different sides, it's not really debatable. Our number one money-making sign is Taurus. And that's the action. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. And of course, we'll try to answer them in the weekly Love Hopes Horoscopes video. And that's it. I'm having fun with these. I'm having fun with this list. From thesunnyside.net, I'm Sunny, thanking everyone in advance for sharing the videos on Facebook or on a YouTube playlist, and for encouraging me to make these lists. They're a lot of fun. And again, I think that's it. From thesunnyside.net, I'm Sunny, wishing everyone the absolute best of a beautiful week, and I'll see you soon.